Hello, everybody. It's Richard, and you're watching the 5 Days, 5 Gays collab.
Hey!
Come on.
It's time to get on. We party all night long. And we ain't afraid of morning. We can get the stops.
I'm glad you joined me here today. This week's theme is most embarrassing moment. And I do have one, but I'm going to save it for the last. First, I'm going to answer all the guys' questions. Clyde's question was, what is the meaning of life? I mean, please, Clyde, that is so difficult to answer. I don't really know what the meaning of life is, but I do know that one should live their life to the fullest. And especially when they're young, they should take advantage of as many opportunities as they possibly can, because normally you only get those chances once in your lifetime. And if you pass them up, you will be very sorry later. Trust me, there are things that I wish I had done that I have not. Although I have lived a very fulfilling life so far, and I'm quite pleased with the way everything has turned out. So I'm not putting it down if you don't do everything, but those things that you truly want to do, I would say you should. And the meaning of life is probably to take advantage of the things that life offers. Now, Andy's question is, do you like spring cleaning? Absolutely not. I don't know anyone who likes to do spring cleaning or any cleaning anytime. I don't know of anyone who really likes to do it. I guess there are some people that are obsessed with it, but I'm not one of them. And I don't like to do spring cleaning, but it is one of those necessary things that must be done. As a matter of fact, I do cleaning almost all the time, so, you know, something gets dusty, I want to clean it. Doesn't mean that you won't find dust in my house, because I'm sure there's plenty of that to go around, but spring cleaning, yeah, it needs to be done. I have to do it, so I do it, not because I want to or because I like to, but because it's a necessary evil. Now, Zach's question was, who is your best friend? My best friend is my husband and lover, James. We have been together for 18 years, and I can't think of anybody that I could call a better friend than him. He has been my best friend, I guess, since well into our relationship back in the 90s. So I'm going to say that he's my best friend, because as of right now, I mean, we do everything together, and still enjoying it after all of this time. We very rarely have any arguments. We do have disagreements, but very rarely have a crossword with one another, and really enjoy being around one another. So my best friend is my lover, hope to be married to one day, James. So that's the answer. James, I hope that was the answer that you were looking for. Now, Thomas has a rather difficult question to answer as well, but not as difficult as Clyde's, I don't think. But his question is, what song from the 80s would you say would best describe yourself? And I don't know if it really describes me, but it describes how I feel. And I think that song is one that was done by the Spandau Ballet. The title of the song is True. And there are words in the second verse of that song that says,
I wanna take it to the world, but now I've come back again.
Something that needs to be said, and I'm one for saying truth, so Consequently, that means a lot to me, and always has ever since I first heard that song. And I liked it then, I still like it now. And so that song is probably the song that I would say best describes my feelings, and, you know, maybe me, not so much me as a person, but describes how I feel about things. So, now my question for this week is, do you like sports? And if you do, then do you play any sports, and what sport would that be? The answer to that for me is that I've never been much of a sports fan. I did play Little League Baseball when I was a kid, only because a friend of my dad's was like the coach of the team, I think. And but I guess I was good enough. He did make me pitcher, and I, you know, pitched for, I guess, the couple of years that I did play on that team. But I don't think I ever really enjoyed it so much. I think it was just something that I felt like it was a need to do. And so that's what I did. And now for the theme this week, my most embarrassing moment. I can think of the one that probably has lingered on my mind for many years. I was with some friends, this was quite a few years ago, down in Florida, and we were just a little bit north of the South Beach area, and we had gone out into the ocean there, you know. And in South Beach, I don't, if you haven't been there, then you wouldn't know, but on South Beach, when you walk out into the water, you have to go quite a ways before you can get into anything deep, because the sandbars go quite a ways out, and most of the way out you can stay in water that is only about waist deep. But as the water whips through there, it pulls and tugs at you, so it's a little bit hard to walk through. And I was there with friends, and I was going to come back onto the beach, and a pretty good sized wave came through, and I was, you know, putzing through there, and it caught my body and grabbed my swimming suit and zipped it right off of my body, swept it over the sandbar out into the deeper part of the ocean. I was not going to go out there and get it. I wanted to, but I wasn't going to. So consequently, there I was just buck naked out in the ocean on South Beach, where there's lots and lots of people on the beach. So whenever I came back up, I had to walk naked in front of quite a few people, and I think the embarrassing part was that all of these ladies with their whistles and howls that made me, you know, until I got back to my towel. So that was embarrassing, and I guess that's probably my most embarrassing moment. If you haven't already subscribed to 5 Days, 5 Gays, then please do that now. You can do that right down here. Hit the subscribe button. And check out all of the other guys and my personal channels, and subscribe to those too, because everybody puts out some pretty good stuff on their own personal channels too. And I think some videos that you'd enjoy. And so please do that and help us out with that. And if you have any comments to make, please do that down below. And if you have questions, or if you have some suggestions for any themes or questions that could be asked, leave those below too, because we do read all of those comments, and we appreciate you coming in and watching. So I'm Richard. That's it for Wednesday. I'll see you next week. Bye.